you want to know her well, so I want to share her curriculum vitae. Okay, okay. This is her curriculum vitae, Buhani. Buhani is midwife and lecturer at Unisula. Okay, and public health specialist, independent lactation counselor. So lecturer and counselor, and then part of Women Deliver Young Leader. Wow, young leader also. And also I think active in Muhammadiyah, Nasihatul Aisyah. And about her education, graduated from primary school, Muhammadiyah 8, Semarang. And then MTSMA Mu'alimat, Muhammadiyah Semarang. And how to say
Jogja, Jogja.
Oh, sorry, Muhammadiyah Yogyakarta. And Midwife University Muhammadiyah Semarang, and Midwife Stikes Karya Husada, and then Master of, I think
Public Fry,
Master of Public Health, yes, MPH is
Public Health.
Yes, Master of Public Health, how to say, Fritz, is that Netherlands?
Fry University.
Why university?
Fry. It should be Fry.
Fry, okay, because that's not English, right? Fry University Amsterdam. Okay. Oh, that's very interesting. Yes. Okay. And also, she is active as the speaker in international conference, in Asia Pacific Religion Conference, and then Women Deliver Conference and Women Deliver Conference also. Yeah. But the level is Asia Pacific. That's excellent. And then award, she got awards and grant. The first award is Women Deliverer and Johnson and Johnson. That is from international, comprehensive. Can you tell us about this? SRHR education to empower street children. What does it stand for?
SRHR means sexual reproductive health and rights.
Oh my God. Okay, that's interesting. And World Alliance for Breastfeeding Action. Okay. That's about Buhani, still young, but always still young, but she is a young leader and has a good contribution in Asia Pacific regional, not only in Indonesia. Wow. We have special speaker here, Ibu Hani. Okay, Ibu Hani, I will remind everyone here that you only have around 15 or 20 minutes to share. Yes. Okay, 20 minutes. To share your experience about studying and living in Netherlands. And then after that, we will only have one session. That's 4 questions. I think that's enough, only one session. Or if you want another session, if we still have time, that's fine, but maybe only 1 or 2 more questions. Okay, and because mostly of the students here maybe understand English, but maybe not really fluent in English, I think for students, you can ask in Indonesia or in Bahasa. But if you can, please try to ask in English. Okay. So during the presentation of Ibu Hani, absolutely you can give like a short comment or just to show that you are engaging in her presentation, not sleepy or going anywhere. So give a short comment or just asking clarification during her presentation. I think that's fine, but not asking questions that need a long explanation, because that will be best if you ask the question in the session, in the discussion or question and answer session. Okay, Buhani, are you ready? I don't get your PowerPoint yet, so
yeah. I will present by myself.
I will let you to share yourself. Okay, share screen. Yes, you can share now.
Yes. Thank you, Bu Hida. Actually, Bu Hida is just like my sister, because her younger sister is my good friend. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon.
There is Bu Made here, Bu Trimanah, and Bu Ida also, if I'm not mistaken.
Bu Ida, yeah. Really? Where is she? Okay.
And yeah. And also all the students.
Pak Lizam, Pak
Thank
Lizam,
you. Pak Lizam. Oh, Pak Lizam. Pak Lizam from Cilat. Okay. Thank you for joining our discussion today. I'm sorry if my English is not really good because very long time I didn't practice my English. I don't go anywhere also.
Me too.
So my English getting bad. Getting worse.
Me too.
Yeah. Yeah, thank you. So I would like to share my study journey in Holland. Holland means Netherlands or Belanda, yeah. They call Holland Dutch also, and their national language is Dutch actually. So we begin from here. I took my master degree from Vrije University Amsterdam in the capital city of Netherlands, and this is my history. So my graduation, I would like to share how to get the scholarship and how to get study there. So I will give a short history about my journey to get a scholarship. So I was graduated from Diploma Midwifery in 2009, and 2010 graduated from Sarjana or Bachelor or Diploma 4. And then I tried to get a LOA, letter of acceptance from abroad or foreign universities. And here, actually, I have a story with the, actually, I was failed to get a six. I was refused by 10 universities and 6 scholarships.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Wow. Strong woman.
I'm struggling. I'm really starting to get this opportunity to study in Holland. So actually, when I was graduated, I planned to take a master degree in Australia, but really very difficult to get the LOA from there. I applied also IDS, Australia Development Scholarship, two times.
Yeah.
Twice, and both are failed. And also some universities in UK, United Kingdoms, and also some scholarship from other countries. And finally, I get the scholarship from Dikti, and I got LOA from Netherlands, from KIT, Royal Tropical Institute, or Vrije University Amsterdam, and LOA from Taiwan. Taiwan University. But then the Dikti chose it is better to go to Holland than Taiwan. So I went to Holland. And then when I around 1 month before I went to Holland, I got the announcement that I was invited to interview for Amina Fulbright scholarship to to America, yeah.
Okay, Aminef, okay. And then, why did you choose Netherlands? Oh my God, what's the matter with Ibu Hani? Wow, okay. There is the problem with the connection, Bu Made. Okay, Bu Hani, Bu Hani told us about how struggle she is to get scholarship. So before successfully getting scholarship in Amsterdam, so she failed in several or in some scholarship foundation.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes, so.
Yeah. Because, never give up. Okay. Never give up. Her spirit is very good. Never give up. Yeah.
Yeah. And she lost the connection.
So okay. No worries. We get
so many inspired by Bu Hani, but we will waiting for her.
Okay. Maybe. No worries.
Mela already joined.
Who? Bu Nela.
Bu Nela.
Bu Nela nih. Hawaii.
Assalamualaikum Bu Nela.
Bagus. Where is Bu Nela? The meeting
tour is different between in the chat and in the what's pamphlet.
Oh, I'm very sorry because I think it's already right, Bu.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So
what the alphabet
and yes, alphabet and alphabet and is always it small
and yes. okay thank you. Maybe next time I will prepare for
is there something
thank you,
wrong?
Bumadi,
is there something wrong in the leaflet?
No, not wrong. Just capital and
yes, capital and not
capital. So it's difficult to join the class if we just insert from the pamphlet.
Oh really? Oh my God! Oh, Bu Hani is joining us at the moment. Is trying to join us. Okay. Oh, I'm so sorry because she has a not good connection, internet connection.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello again, Bu Hani.
Hello again. Okay.
Alhamdulillah.
Oh,
I'm sorry. I'm lost.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Yeah.
My connection was good in the morning, even at noon also. I don't know what happened. I don't know what happened.
Sometimes it's happened.
Yeah. So this is the look like of my campus.
Okay.
Ooh, very
nice,
huh?
Wonderful.
Harry Potter nice. Castle.
Yeah, just like Harry Potter Castle.
Yes.
But this is in Holland, not in UK.
Yeah.
So this is actually the name of the campus is Royal Tropical Institute, but they collaborate with the Free University to have a master course for public health.
Very beautiful.
Yeah, it is just like Unisula. So this is the course and the module. So what is differences between the method, the learning method between Netherlands and Indonesia? Some of them is just like one is the teacher. Mostly the teacher are expert, very expert. For example, if we want to talk about the maternal health, so the lecture will be from WHO.
Okay.
So if you want to talk about the we have a model in child health. Child health. So the lecture from UNICEF. So just like that. So they just came to Netherlands, and then they lecture. They have a lecture in my campus, and then they will go back to their country.
Okay. Yeah.
From UK, from Switzerland, from Spain, from Barcelona, from everywhere, the lecture. And we also mostly we have a discuss and we have a like a group practice or how you call this. Mostly discuss, yeah. Not everything in lecture, like kuliah pakar we called, yeah, in Indonesia. And also we visited the red district, red light district, red district, yeah, red light district. The prostitution, the biggest prostitution, one of the biggest prostitution in the world, in Amsterdam. So we visit that place to discuss with the PSK or sex worker there, how they get sexual reproductive health services like a pap smear and other service, health service that they should get it. And we also visited the Switzerland in Geneva, WHO headquarters, and also UN, yeah, PBB, Kantor PBB. And finally, when I graduated, my parents came to Netherlands.
Nice.
Yeah. So this is the five things that, actually four things that we have to do when we start studying in Netherlands. So when I went to Netherlands, I only get the visa for 3 months. And then when I arrived in Netherlands, so I should get my resident card or KTP. Because my visa only for 3 months. So this is my KTP or resident card. And then I have to go to the Gemeente. Gemeente, this is kantor kelurahan, yeah. This look like kantor kelurahan. I should give a report. I told them that I living in this place. I'm studying in this campus and etc. And then I have to be tested TB test in Hihidi. Hihidi look similar to Puskesmas maybe, yeah. Hihidi. Hihidi, but we call Hihidi. So if you want to pronounce gay in Netherlands, will be he.
Oh, he. Oh.
Yeah, he. Yeah, he.
Hihidi.
Yeah, Hihidi. Hihidi. Okay. And just like if we want to say good morning, we say Guten Morgen.
Guten Morgen. Like Germany.
Yeah. Yeah, just like Germany. Exactly. That's why I don't like Dutch.
Oh,
I don't
like that in pronounce that.
Yeah, Bumadi.
This
make us thirsty, yeah? Ha, ha, ha. And then, yeah, we meet the KBRI. KBRI, the Burutno, yeah, Menteri Luar Negeri, the current Menteri Luar Negeri was our what is that, embassy ambassador, yeah, was our ambassador. So we meet the KBRI and then we have an opening ceremony. At that time I'm the only one in student from Indonesia at the time.
Okay, so quite long journey.
Yeah. So this is my flat, student flat, the apartment, very sederhana. But this is in 15th floor, if I'm not mistaken. 15th floor.
15.
My apartment. Fifth. Yeah.
Okay.
The room is private, but the kitchen, the bathroom also private, but the kitchen is shared with the other
students. Okay.
Yeah.
The students.
So there are 5 buildings. Students. There are 5 buildings with a different color. So my building was pink color. Yeah, the student flat. So I got the fridge and microwave.
Small fridge.
All this thing is from fridge. And this is all free. From I don't know, this is from the apartment or from my campus, I don't know. I or think both are collaborate to prepare these things.
Or is it possible?
I think both collaborate
students,
from
right? From previous students, maybe.
No.
Oh no.
No. It should be clean. If we leave the room, it should be clean, everything clean.
Everything is taken from there.
I think no. Yeah.
So it's just for one person.
Yes, for one person. So and also we can drink from the tap, yeah. The water, we don't need to buy mineral water, but yeah,
you can drink anywhere, right?
So we just yeah, we can drink from here, from the Wastafel.
Yeah,
from the Wastafel. Yeah, we can drink.
Really?
Yeah.
In Australia too.
Yes. And also, this is there is a hot water and cold water.
Cold water, yeah.
Because it's when the winter season is very cold. So this is there is a, how we call it? Heater, yeah,
heater.
There is heater here close to the window. Yeah.
We have so usually electric blanket, electrical blanket,
blanket.
No, you don't have it. Okay.
No, I don't have it. Yeah. I don't have it. Usually, I jemur. How to say jemur in English? Jemur here in heater.
How to say jemur? Sunbath.
How to say jemur?
Bahasa Jawa is
sunbath. What is we there? What is Bu Ida? Bu Ida is
jemur pakaian apa menjemur badan?
Jemur pakaian.
Jemur pakaian.
Fry, simple fry.
Fry. Oh yes, fry. Fry.
Fry.
Fry.
Fry.
Fry.
Fry. Fry like goreng ya, goreng.
Yeah, I think so. Fry. F-R-Y, yeah, fry.
Why? F-R-Y.
Eh, Bu Prof.
Really?
Bu Prof. Ita is joining.
Why?
Yeah,
fry. Okay, fry. Usually I used to fry my clothes here in the heater. So
is there a washing machine?
There is washing machine, but we have to pay. In other building, there is a washing machine.
Oh,
but usually, you can see here, yeah, attack, attack softener.
You can bring it from Indonesia.
Yes, even rice also I bring from Indonesia, 1 kg I think. Yeah, for the first time, there is a funny story because I brought my rice 1 kg and I put it in my luggage, my small luggage, and then when we transit in Kuala Lumpur, the X-ray examination, they say that there is something there, and then I have to they ask to open my luggage, and they all are laughing because there is rice there.
Okay, I see.
Because yeah, I worried that I couldn't find rice in Amsterdam, but actually so many different rice in Amsterdam.
Oh really?
Oh,
that's
yeah,
good.
Different rice. There is a Thailand rice, there is Indonesian rice.
I just can't
Indian
find
rice. So many rice.
I just could find Thailand rice in Australia. Just one type of rice, and very very how to say keras.
Very, oh yeah, we have
tough,
basmati.
Tough.
We have also Indonesian rice. We
nice.
Many things different of rice.
Yeah.
Usually €1 1 kg. Yeah. So the transportation we use a bicycle because Dutch people like cycling, yeah.
Yeah, that's nice.
Yeah, and Dutch people also they the tallest people in the world, yeah. The Dutch people. And because that I use the kids bicycle.
Yeah,
this is actually the size of the kids.
Very small Indonesian body.
Yeah.
Very
so
small.
I bought the bicycle for kids. There is a tram here, and this is the musola in my campus.
Yeah,
they have one room that we can use that for pray and also for pumping, breastfeeding.
Okay.
Yeah. There is a one room for that. So we used to pray here.
This one. Oh,
yeah.
Here.
This one.
Oh, breastfeeding and also a prayer.
For praying. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Next to this room, there is a toilet. But you know, in Europe, there is no kran, yeah, kran tap with tempat wudu like that. Place special for
yeah.
So,
we know that.
So I wudu in wastafel, and then I use a bottle. I use a bottle to wash my
like.
Wash my what is that
like.
my leg. And then I was also teach Indonesian
language. Oh, bahasa.
No.
Indonesian
I
word.
Did
oh,
and how to say ikro. This is ikro.
Okay.
Yeah.
Quranic method. Teaching method.
Yeah, because
reading method. Okay.
When I went to grocery, I meet Indonesian that married with Dutch, and actually she is Muslim, but she never pray. And also she forget how to read Al-Quran. Abata and they also forget how to read that.
Oh my
she asked me to teach her and her sister and her kids also, the whole family.
Okay.
So I went there usually when Saturday and Sunday. When after teach Iqra, they give me envelope with the money and I refuse. I refuse it. And
why?
I think I just abata, and then I love to teach also.
Just want to
help.
Yeah,
so yeah, I just want to help. So I told them that no need to pay, just become a family. After that, and the next day, they went to my apartment and they fill with anything that I don't have, even television. They bring a coat, they bring a boots, everything that I don't have, they give it to me.
Buhani, yeah. you will only have 5 minutes more.
Oh my God. And also very easy to find halal food because mostly Netherlands, there is so many immigrants in Holland. There is Surinams, Indonesia, Asia, Morocco, Timur Tengah, Arab, so many people from there, from that country. So very easy to find halal food. We have also the PPI in Amsterdam. In Amsterdam, we are around 50 students, Indonesian students in Amsterdam, only Amsterdam. In other city, we also have so many Indonesian students. This is the PPI Amsterdam. And below is we picnic to Belgium, and all of this is Indonesian students from Holland, from different cities in Holland. We visited Belgium, and this is when I was graduated, and this is my parents.
Because that's close from Holland, right? Like just by
bus.
Yeah,
very close by bus. Yeah,
nice.
From Amsterdam, I went to Germany, Düsseldorf, only 3 hours by bus, and also to Belgium, also 3 hours by bus. And to go to Paris by bus, it took 7 hours, around 7 hours to Paris.
Yeah, it's like from Jawa Barat to Jawa Tengah, yeah? like that.
Yeah.
From East Java to Central Java just by bus. Wow.
Yeah, just like Semarang to Jogja.
Yeah, that's why you can go around Europe from Holland or Netherlands.
Yes, yes.
Nice.
So after graduation, we visited Paris. I went to also Alpen, from Italy, Germany.
Snowing.
Alpen, Italia, in Turin, in Juventus Stadium. And also Spain, Spanish, Barcelona, Belgium,
nice.
Switzerland, France. This is the big MAJT-nya Paris. MAJT-nya Paris. The mosque in Paris. This is Eiffel. This is Hitoren. Hitoren is the small village with no road, without road. So only there is canal and with
a boat. Okay, canal and boats.
We call canal. Yeah.
Never flooding there.
No.
Not like in our
country. Never. This is Keukenhof. Keukenhof is like the tulip garden. Yeah, tulip garden.
Beautiful garden.
Yeah, very beautiful. And okay.
Yeah, if you go to Netherlands, you can go in all the Europe countries.
Yeah, because very close
it's
each other.
It's just like open the door from Netherlands and go to all of the countries of Europe.
Yes, true. So this is the benefit after coming back to Indonesia. There is so many opportunities that I could get.
Well, okay. Mostly of my
public speaking.
Yeah. Okay.
And then this is the scholarship. I don't think so that I need to talk about this, yeah.
Okay. Oh, wait. Yeah. 1 minute more?
Wait. Yeah. If, finish.
Yeah. finish. Okay. Yeah. I think you don't need to share your screen anymore, Bu Hani.
Yes.
Okay. Okay. Everyone, especially the student here, some student here around 35 or 40. Bu Hani has given the presentation about living and studying in Netherlands. That is very interesting, and I think it can inspire you to go there. You are still undergraduate now. Different with us, the lecturers here. Yeah, maybe if you want to go there, maybe just for conference or maybe for seminar. But for all of you, it's really time for you to ask more or in-depth information from Bu Hani, especially maybe asking her about the quality of education there. Yeah. Bu Hani has explained it about the learning method. It's like always teaching by the expert and then always dealing with the real experience. Real experience means related to the subject that you were taken. And I think there will be something interesting more about education there, because mostly here you are student. Maybe if you have any question related to her experience, you can ask in Indonesian or in English. Boleh bahasa Indonesia. You can ask in Indonesian or in English. Okay. Is there any question for the student here? There are some student, or well, or you can just write on the chat. Yeah, maybe you need to have Bu Hani contact number or just email, anything. You can ask her. This is a good experience for you. Yeah, to know Bu Hani closer and closer, and then get information about to be in Netherlands, studying there, living there by scholarship. Okay. You can write on the chat also. Okay, well, we think the question from participant, especially from the students. Is there any comment, Bu Made, or Bu Ida, or Bu Mela, or maybe Bu Profita? I could find the Bu Profita is also here. And also Bu Trimana, maybe, if she is not busy with her kids. Is there any comment or question? Bu Made?
Bu Ida, raise hand.
Bu Ida. Okay, Bu Ida, please, if you want to ask a question, Bu Ida.
Bu Hani would like to share her experience, a unique experience during living in Holland, maybe. Very unique, and with, when deal with the language barrier or something. Thank you very much.
Can you catch the question from
Bu Ida? I don't get it.
Yeah, because the voice is not clear. Yeah, it's quite.
I think she only say.
Let me repeat. What about now? Is it clearer?
Yeah, it is clear now.
Okay. I think you are in the bus. Yes, are you in the bus?
In feeder right now.
Feeder. Yeah. Feeder. All time I don't do the feeder.
Okay.
Actually, many people like to share her experience, unique experience during her living in Holland. Maybe deal with language barrier or something like this. Thank you.
The language barrier.
Yes, language barriers.
Yes. Mostly Dutch people can speak in English, different with other people, other countries in Europe. Just when you visited Paris, very difficult to find people can speak in English. Even the police, even the shopkeeper, they cannot speak in English mostly. But in Holland, most of people can speak in English, even children, because they used to speak English also.
Can or cannot?
They can speak in English.
Okay, good.
In Holland, different with other countries in Europe.
Okay.
Just like when we visited Paris or Spain, very difficult to find people
who can speak English. Okay.
Yes. Because Paris is more people. Paris French. More what is ego? Yes, they like to speak French more than English.
So English is not really global language.
In Paris, yes.
Yes.
Okay, so you didn't get any problem. You didn't get any problem.
Oh, no, but I get when I was in Paris. My cell phone was took by robber in Paris, and I saw the pickpocket. There is no people help me
because they don't know pickpocket, or they know.
I'm not sure, but I don't know. I'm not sure.
Oh, okay. But with your English, so that means your English is good, because mostly my the student in Australia, when they were in Australia for 1 month, the first 1 or 2 months, they always have problem when dealing with the native speaker there, when they go to the market, traditional market, something like that. And then the problem is always with the listening for the first 1 month, okay, because they speak so fast. And it's quite different with the with the campus. In the campus, it is clearer because mostly the teacher and the student can speak slower, and they understand that we are not English speaker, we are ASEAN, so they speak much slower than the native, like in the market when we met them in the market. So we always have problem, the students, when going to Australia for the first 1 month or 2 months, having the problem with the listening. But then it is fine. In the third month, it's really fine. Kalau sudah 3 bulan loh, kok paham ya?
They
speak so fast.
I feel so. Mostly is the benefit. Also. Yeah. This is the benefit study in Holland, because English is not their national language, so they speak English not really fast like UK people. That is the benefit.
Okay.
And mostly I have a English trouble with my classmate from Africa. Their English very different with the English from Holland. Like very, very fast, and there is a pronounce like very difficult to explain. The pronounce is very different, so difficult
to deal with
and also from India, and also from India.
Nehi. I think that quite the different English.
English, different English. They in India people also speak in English, right, in their country,
right.
But their English, their English is very
Indian accent.
Indian accent.
That quite funny sometimes. That must be challenging also with Indian, African, or the native, but with that never dealing or just seldom dealing with the international students. They speak very fast with mostly slang also for the young native speakers.
Yep.
So we feel so comfort in the environment of our campus, but when we go outside from the campus and then we go like to the traditional market, or we go to the cinema, or we visit our friends, and then we need to communicate with the native for the first 1 or 2 months, we really have problem with our listening. And oh my God, how come we don't really catch up the meaning what they have talking, where they have talk about something. Okay, is there any comment? And then there, student, hello. If you don't really understand, this is just to motivate you, to study English harder, Okay.
Yeah, Bu Melia. Bu Melia.
I want to ask.
Okay, Bu Meli.
Will you go back to Holland for your PhD, or you try to apply to another country?
Okay, thank you. I'm planning to take a PhD in UK or in Holland, but I'm not sure. Now I'm not sure, but I'm planning to get PhD there.
Okay.
In Holland, because I was living there, so I used to with the environment in Holland.
Uh-huh.
And UK is London also not really very close with Amsterdam also, London. So I wish to take my PhD in UK or in Holland.
Nice. That's very nice. Actually, that's also my dream to take PhD in Europe. But no, you know, because my husband doesn't love me to take, to study abroad again. So
this is our problem. That is our problem.
At the moment, I take the PhD, the doctoral degree in Indonesia.
Because it is okay. Yeah,
that's really next, challenging. PhD is challenging because you have to leave Indonesia for 4 years. Mm. And that would be the problem if your husband also have a job here in Indonesia and couldn't accompanying you there.
Yes, true.
You will have a very, very challenging problem. Like not problem, challenging case, yeah. Like something like if your husband cannot accompany you to study in Europe or in other country or abroad, study abroad. What about your children? Will they with you? Yeah. They with you too, or with your husband, or will you live separate with them for 4 years?
No, I don't want to
because studying in Europe is very costly. You know, there is no support for family also. That's quite challenging, I think.
But from LPDP and Dikti, there is a scholarship for the family, yeah?
Yeah, I think so. Good. Yeah. Yeah, just try to find.
But the problem is dealing with the husband. The problem is dealing with the husband.
Yeah, always like that, dealing with the husband. Okay, we still have 7 minutes. Is there any question or comment from anyone here? Indonesian language, it's okay. Indonesian language. Maybe from Arina. Okay, from Zaki. Is there?
This is FIE students.
Yeah.
All of them?
Mostly FIE student, English club, and Bumade usually. Bumade and Bu Ida students also. I'm really interested about your explanation about learning method, learning method. Mostly the teacher is expert, so that's quite different from Indonesia, right? I mean, like this one, when we are studying about teaching, if we study in Netherlands, should be taught by expert teacher, right? Because someone who is expert in the field. Not like in our country, maybe the lecturer, when they are also the lecturer in the teaching faculty, not always having an experience of teaching at school. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah. Just like midwife too.
We are
midwife, but we don't work in the hospital or in clinic, yeah? But we teach midwife students, just like that.
Yeah. So the expert, the teacher is also the expert now. I mean that they know about the strength, the weaknesses, and also the problem in their field, and really can make the closer experience from the, the knowledge and the experience closer to the theory. Do you know what I mean?
Because
they are the expert. They are the expert. In the field. Okay. Do you have any problem with the culture? I think you look very happy there. Do you have any experience related to how to say not good experience in dealing with the cultural problem. Yeah, well, maybe ras. Like my sister studying in America. Yeah, she got the problem. Yeah, she got the problem with Islamophobia, something like that.
Yeah,
she got the problem about dealing with Islamic phobia with her hijab.
Maybe because in Netherlands, that I told before, in so many immigrant, yeah, in Netherlands from Timur Tengah country, how we call Timur Tengah, yeah, Eastern Asia, Eastern Asia, yeah,
Middle East Asia.
So many people were hijab there, so it is not strange, not strange people if you use veil, because many people use this.
So Dutch
people, they usually actually they are Nasrani, but usually they don't have
nice.
A God. Yeah, they're nice atheist. And they atheist. Yeah, the church, so many church that the functions become a supermarket, become a market, become apartment like that, because no one come to church, no one go to church, so the church. The functional of the church become a flat or become a apartment, become a market like that.
Many people are atheists, but they respect people who is applying their religion, by wearing their hijab or ring. Okay.
Even my teacher, some of my teacher has a blood, how to say blood. Ada hubungan darah ya, blood relationship with Indonesia. Like grandmother, their grandmother from Indonesia, from Lamongan, grandfather from Ungaran, like that. Yeah.
Can they speak Javanese?
Suriname, they can speak Java. But for Dutch people, they can speak the Java.
Suriname is okay. Because mostly Suriname speak Javanese.
Yeah. Yeah. When graduation, they serve Indonesian food, ramesan, nasi campur. Ora ari buncis, tempe, tahu.
They love that.
They love Indonesian food.
So, are you really recommend Netherlands for the student here? Jadi really
very very recommend. Very recommend.
Okay, good. Okay, so having no really problem with the culture,
no
really problem with the practice of our religion, and also finding several places to take, to refresh our mind, maybe.
Yeah.
To refresh
even
our mind.
Even in Amsterdam, there is two mosques. Indonesian mosque. Usually mosque in Amsterdam, mosque by country. There is a mosque for Moroccan people, there is a mosque for Indian people, there is a mosque for Indonesian people. So the mosque usually based on their country.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Indonesia has two mosques in Amsterdam. The big mosque.
So it is really nice to practice our religion there, yeah? No problem.
Yes. So many mu'alaf, yeah? When I, in Ramadan, after Tarawih, usually there is Dutch people who become Islam.
You are so lucky, I think. I mean that in Australia, we only have one mosque that is in the big city, very far from my campus.
This is also far.
Yeah. Yeah, two hours to go there. I need to spend 2 hours to go there. So it's impossible for me for Taraweh there. So I just Taraweh at my unit. Lonely or with friends, something like that. So very sad in Ramadan time.
Okay. But good fasting time. Fasting time in in Australia is good, yeah? Only
yeah. Oh, no, good. What do you mean by good? No,
only I think the time is shorter than Europe. Yes. Oh, we 19 fasting.
That is in winter. But summer. Yeah, but in summer that's very long time.
Yeah.
Yeah. In winter just 9 hours. We are so lucky. In winter just 9 hours. Yeah. But in summer you have to spend more than 18 hours. Oh my god.
Yeah.
Okay.
19.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay, 19
mine.
For you.
Yeah, in Amsterdam 19.
Oh,
19
okay.
Hours.
Quite close to Australia when winter.
Yeah.
Okay, Bu Hani, I think it's very lovely experience, and because time is over, so I'm so sorry that we have to finish this nice sharing session experience, and I do hope from your presentation, mostly the student here can get an inspiration and motivation to have a dream, and also action, studying hard, and never be hesitate to, I mean that, to have a dream to go to Europe or to go to US or to go to other developed country to get good knowledge and experience of studying there, and then share to our country. Okay, like Bu Hani, I think Bu Hani had an experience to study in Netherlands and never give up, you know, 9 times failure. So I think she is very strong woman. I mean, that's strong, you know, because finally she could reach her dream to be in Netherlands, although fail for several times. Okay,
yes.
So for you, the student who have a dream, please keep spirit.
Yeah, feel free.
Yeah
feel free to discuss, yeah.
Yeah, keep spirit and then study hard and also be persistent to reach your dream. And also please keep in touch with Bu Hani. Okay, Bu Hani, how to keep in touch with you? Because in your CV, there is no address for contacting you.
There is in the top, the left.
Okay, no worries.
But you can see
which one? Yeah.
In the CV,
okay.
In the CV there is also.
In the CV here. Yeah, okay, please student, you or any lecturers here who are interested to know more about studying in Netherlands, especially for master degree, please contact Bu Hani. Okay.
Yeah, feel free to contact me.
Yeah, feel free to contact Bu Hani. Okay, Bu Hani, okay. I think I don't need to give conclusion because this one, my son, at the moment is joining with us. So I think it's enough for today. Okay, let's close our session.
Thank you so much.
Okay, thank you so much, Bu Hani, for your sharing session. Let's close our meeting by sharing hamdalah together.
Alhamdulillahirabbil alamin.
Okay, thank you so much. Turn on your camera. I will take your picture, please. Oh, okay. Okay. Thank you so much. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdika asyhadu an la ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka wa atubu ilaik. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.